Nala girl.
Yo, what up? Welcome back to another video. That's Nala. Hopefully she's gonna be my new fishing dog. She's a little bit young yet to come fishing. She's only like 10 weeks old, but when she's fully vaccinated and a bit bigger, she'll be coming and doing the thing. She's a lab cross GSP. Anyway, it's like midday. I've just got back from down in the South Island. Caught some nice fish down there. Two videos to come from that trip. I haven't got anything set up. Like, I've just got reels, just got blank rods. I don't know where anything is, or yeah. So I've got to sort it all out, but that's what I was going to show you, because I have done a couple of videos on it in the past, which I can link up here. But generally, you guys are always asking me how do I, what my setups are, how do I put them together, and all that sort of thing. So I'll show you a bit about that today. Maybe something else, I don't know. But yeah, I got like once I get all my gear together, I got like a 40-minute drive to get to the Tongariro. My plan is to catch two fish, one fish nymph, one fish swim. This is the boot.
I haven't showed you guys this thing for ages, but this has been running me 6 months now, and it's almost brand new. Not endorsed or anything by Orvis, but I cannot recommend this boot enough. I've gone through all sorts of others, specifically Patagonia boots. I've trashed those things real easy. But the Orvis, I don't even know what it's called. I think it's called an Orvis Pro. Just freaking bulletproof.
All right, so the rod that I have been frequently using, my favorite rod at the moment, made by Loop. Loop is the sponsor of mine, and I've supported me for a long time, so I'm not sure if a lot of you guys knew that. I haven't really, you know, I don't like to push, you know, products and things like that too heavily. I want it to be genuine. I want it to be stuff that I really use and really like. This is the cheapest rod they make, and it's also my current favorite rod they make. It's a Loop Q, 6 weight. I've spoken about it a million times before, but if you want to get yourself one, if you live in New Zealand, if you follow the link below and use the discount code THNZ, you get, I believe it's 10% off. But yeah, this thing's a weapon. It is absolutely ideal paired with a Rio Grande, which is quite a weight forward. You know, all the weight in the taper is really, really far forward. So this rod, Rio Grande, 6 weight, really super ideal for fishing the Tongariro and roll casting and, you know, big heavy rigs. I've been using it everywhere though. I've been using it in the backcountry. I just really like it. It's just a really good rod. The reel I've been using with it is the Loop Q. It looks from afar almost identical to the dry fly. It's that kind of look. It's probably slightly wider. Compared to the dry fly and the the G4, I think it's called, the Evotech G4. I mean, those reels certainly are a cut above. They are essentially indestructible. But I just got some people coming, so I'll have to stop talking because they'll think I'm weird. So yeah, like I was saying, that's the Loop Q. It's very, very similar to an Opti dry fly, but it's, I mean, the Opti dry fly is definitely a cut above, but these are still, for the price they are, they're absolute money. I've trashed this thing already. You can see the bottom of it's all beat up. It's fallen out of the back of the truck. Dropped it on rocks, and it's really, really good. So I think you can get this combo for like $600 minus 10% if you use the discount code. So yeah, Loop's been a great supporter of me. So if you want to go and find something from their website, their New Zealand website, yeah, that'd be cool. Anyway, I've come to this little skinny bit of, it's like a side creek. There's a little bit of water here, and if I go the other side of this island, there's a heap more water. So this is probably like, I don't know, I'd say 30% of the river coming down here, but the good thing is about it is you can sight fish in it. So that's what I'm going to do now. Small indicator, naturals, see if I can pick up a couple of fish sight fishing. I made another little slight boo-boo in the fact that I forgot my net again, so these fish are going to be beached, which isn't ideal, but it is what it is.
All right, so what I'm going to go with is a marginally heavy herring copper. It's like probably about somewhere in the mid-range in terms of weight that's in my box. So yeah, it goes fly line, which is the Rio Grande, and then I've got a loop knot, 10-pound nylon, which is about that long. And then there's quite a few feet. 8-pound down to the herring copper. Then off the tail of this here, I will tie some 6-pound. So there you go, there's the herring copper off the 8-pound, 6-pound off the bend. And then down here, I don't know, about how long is that? A foot-ish. I am going to tie a, I'm still going super natural. So this is a category 3 fly. Both these flies are category 3. This is, I forget what this is called, but it's just a really basic pheasant tail. I think it's called a Hoover actually. All that stuff, especially category 3, that's all linked in the description. You guys ask tons of questions, and quite often everything's linked in the description. So check out those links below if you want to learn a little bit more about what I use. And if you don't, well then just don't look. All right, so now it's time to do the indicator. If I can find the stuff. So this is, that's gone forever. No, it's not, there it is. So this is the XL tubing from, what's the company called? New Zealand Strike Indicator Tubing. It's the big giant stuff. Normally fishing this kind of water, I'd use the small tubing, but I don't actually have any, and I'm gonna be fishing deeper water after it. So I'm just gonna use it. Generally the fish in here aren't too, you know, aren't too picky about what's going on, so hopefully I get away with it. This is the material. Still the New Zealand Strike Indicator tool material. I never used to like this, but it has actually grown on me. I figured out how to use it, which is not to cram too much in. You gotta leave it kind of sparse so it's all springy. And yeah, it does actually work quite well, especially if you use a bit of floatant on top of it. So there's a tube, I hope you saw what I did. There's a, you slide a loop through the tube, put your material in the loop, and then slide the tube up onto them, up onto the, just like that. Yeah, too easy. Give it a nice little haircut. I'm gonna cut this one quite small. And in an attempt to keep it somewhat subtle. Yeah, there's your indicator. With a little bit of floatant, which I am currently using gink. Normally in the winter I use loon, just because it doesn't go so thick. Like on a cold morning, the gink goes like, it's really hard to use, but the loon stays runny year round. All right, I can actually see a fish. Like right there. Really, really close to me. So let's see how this goes. I think that's a fish anyway. If you can see my indicator, that was a little short, so my flies probably went over top of the fish. And he's still there, but he didn't eat it. Right in his face, that one. Right in his face. This is right in his face again. Still didn't eat it. This is right in his face. Still don't need it. Just move right over. I probably pissed him off. I'm gonna change flies though if he doesn't. I'll give him a few. It can be kind of tricky to get it right in there in the kill zone. He's not shown an ounce of interest in it. I'm not hitting the bottom either, so I might just, I'll just slide this indicator another 6 inches up, give me slightly more depth. Really important to fish accurate depth. All right, so he's definitely had the opportunity to see that. So I'm gonna change the point fly. Something with a little more pizzazz. All right, so now this fly is actually tied by a dude named Bevan. I don't know what you call this, sorry, Bevan. Maybe you can comment below if you watch this video. He sells flies commercially in Taupo Rod and Tackle, which is also linked below. He ties some amazing streamers, like some really, really cool looking streamers, and I've caught a bunch of fish on them. So yeah, go check that out. And cheers for the flies, Bevan. Man, this video is full of plugs. Just full of plugs, mate. All right, so
So where's another fish?
Yeah, fishy, 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 fishy.
There should be more than... I think I... That's really hard to see. Hopefully that's a fish. Yep, got him. Wow, this is the world's fastest landing of a fish. If I can keep his head there. Oh, stop, buddy, stop, 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 stop. Oh my God. That's gotta be a record. He came, he did so much thrashing. So that ate Bevan's, whatever this little, it's got purple stuff on it. He smoked it straight away. Nice little hen. Not too bad, actually. Very nice little fish. All right, girlfriend, see you later. Fish number one, complete. Sight fished right on the edge. It was very, very hard to see that fish. He just a little smudge because the water's moving quite fast. But yeah, that was cool. Happy about that. World record time for landing him. He didn't really swim. If he had got the opportunity to swim, I would have taken a lot longer, but he just head shakes. Well, there should definitely be a fish or three right in here. Oh yeah, there's one. Okay, I got one. This is quite a good fish, this one. There could be other fish down there where my indicator is sitting. I'm probably going just too far for this fish. This one here should be good. I should get pretty close. Yeah, oh, I had him. Dang. It's a good fish too. That would have gone 5 pound, that fish. I probably set the hook a little too crazy on him, actually. Now that I replay that in my mind, I got excited. All right, now I have to find another fish. But I know there should be a few. Okay, I see one. This one's gonna be a tricky drift, this one. Right in there somewhere. Got him. Not a bad fish either. My reel's full of sand. I've got this huge chute below me, so if he gets in that, I'm really gonna struggle to land him. So I really gotta work hard to beach him short. He's behaving so far. Nice, beautifully colored up jack. I think this guy's ate the bomb though. Yeah, buddy. Yeah, on the nice sandy beach. It's better for your health. Yeah, buddy. Good boy. Good boy. Yes, good fish. Good fish, yes, good fish. I've just got a new dog, so... Oh, that was only just skin hooked there too. He ate both of them. He ate both flies. I don't know if he just got wrapped up, but I just pulled this one out of the top jaw, and the purple one is, oh, it just popped out, but that was in the lower jaw. Crazy. Really nice looking fish though. Beautiful jack. See you later. Thanks for playing. All right, so I'm just looking now for another fish. Another fish. Where is he? They're quite hard to see in here because, I mean, it's good visibility because you've got the backdrop of the trees, which takes away pretty much all of the glare, but because the surface is so ripply, it's fairly tough. Fairly tough spotting, picking up. When I'm looking for fish, I'm looking for likely size, likely shape, likely color, likely lie. And they never have a hard edge like a rock. A trout will almost always, especially in water like this, just look like a blur. It's kind of like a smudge, a smudgy blur. I know there's got to be another one in front of me. For sure there's got to be one in front of me. Okay, I've just picked one up. This one does actually, maybe it's not a fish. I'm gonna have a cast at it because it, no, I changed my mind. It's not a fish, it's a rock. The old rockfish. Oh, actually, I've just picked one up. Very hard to see, right in center stream. Very difficult to see. He's right in, right there. Got him. Boom. That is some cool fishing. I'm just calling this like crazy. This one looks a little skinnier, but bigger. If he was in better condition, he'd be a better fish. Come here, buddy. Nice gravelly beach over here for you. Nice sandy beach. Come on, mate. This one, again, is eating that little purple fly. Come on. Good fish. Good fish. Good fish. Good fish. Stay there. Stay there. So this one's actually kind of a bit manked up, so I'm not really going to handle it too much or spend too much time with it. You can see this back there has got a bit of damage to it. He's been fighting. Off you go, back to your fighting. I wasn't recording. I spent a while trying to hook this fish. I ended up putting some split shot on. It was a challenging drift. So it took about 20 or 30 casts to get him rather than just one for all the others. But I had a nice mix between that purple fly and the herring copper at the moment. This guy's eating the herring copper. This one's a fairly nice jack, this one. Don't bang yourself on a rock. Chill out. Chill. Chill, chill. Chill.
So a nice jack. Ate that herring copper right in the snout. Took quite a bit to get him. Cool. Quick tip on holding fish. All the pressure is right here. All the control is right there. And they just do as they're told. This is where the control is. This hand does nothing. It looks much better for a photo like that. And yeah, you've got optimum control over the fish. There's nothing else.
See you later, buddy.
Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I really tried hard to deliver some information in this video and tell you guys what I'm using, what I'm up to. Let me know if you liked it. And it was actually quite a fun video to film, so I'll try and do more similar to this in the future. Give you guys some more value out of the videos, because I really appreciate you guys watching. That was a really fun session, sight cast. All of those fish, I didn't catch any blind, which is really fun to do in the middle of winter. I know some of you guys are gonna ask about the fly box that I had in that video. It's actually a loot box. It's been available for quite a few months, but I've only just managed to get one. It's quite different. I haven't seen a box like it, and that it has a nymph section and then some compartments. But this one, I've got all the nymphs through here. Then there's these three little compartments that I've been putting like eggs and, you know, just random stuff in. Eggs, worms, soft tackles, that kind of stuff. And then this whole side is these big long compartments on a diagonal, which I've is filled up with streamers and things like that. So that's working out really well, especially as a winter box, because I always like to have a good amount of streamers in my box during the winters, fishing the Tongariro and places like that and doing all the swing. So being able to have both in the same box is quite convenient. I'll leave links in the description. Whether you're in New Zealand, there'll be a link, or if you're somewhere else, there'll be another link for the Loop, the big Loop website that ships anywhere in the world. Let me know what you thought about this video. Really hope you liked it. Remember to subscribe. If you haven't already, ring that little bell, that little notification bell. That way you'll be notified every time I post a new video, which is every Wednesday, sometimes a little more frequent than that. That's all I have. Thank you guys so much for watching. Really appreciate it. And I will see all of you in the next one. Peace.